This episode of Krazy Ken's Tech Misadventures is sponsored by Linode. Okay, so the public beta for Apple's reimagined macOS, macOS 11 Big Sur, is now out. I feel like it's been longer than normal. Normally we get public betas way sooner. Anyway, let's do an installation sensation. You're coming with me. Hey guys, how are you all doing? Really? That's just great. You know, I'm doing pretty great today too because it's time for that public beta. Let's install it. It's been a while since we've done an installation sensation. Now, we are crazy here, but we're not that crazy. Let me tell you what I mean. This is my daily driver currently. What am I not gonna do? That's right, I'm not gonna install beta software on my daily driver. Maybe on another partition, I don't know. What's safer is we're gonna install it on this La C drive. It's currently running Catalina, but we're gonna put Big Sur public beta on this guy. And we're gonna have some fun with it, test out the new features, see how well it runs for some basic things on an older MacBook Pro, and we're gonna see if some of those user interface things that I constructively complained about in my other video, yeah, we'll see if those were fixed or not. Let's have a look. Right when the refrigerator kicked in, you asshole, I normally turn it off, but this was a long one. Hey, I gotta be fed, you know. Shut up. So here we are in Catalina with 57% battery life left because we like to live dangerously. Let's see if we can get it done before the battery dies. So the La C drive is plugged in over there with the Thunderbolt cable, and it looks like it says update. So it was doing some Big Sur thing at one time because I had the developer beta on there, but now let's get the public beta on there. Let's see if we can format this thing without causing a catastrophic meltdown. There's two containers. Oh my gosh. I still don't really understand what APFS does. Okay, so I think it makes two containers for like protection reasons. I don't know. Why is this under this, but this isn't? Oh my gosh, I have no idea. How do I format this drive? There's like 17 volumes. Jeez. Well, I guess I gotta get with the times, New Roman. Okay. Full reminder, I'm going into this blind. That's kind of the fun of an installation sensation. And then once we get the system working, we'll take it for a test drive to see how well it works, which is even more fun when it's beta software. So yeah, you're coming along for the ride. Oh no. Okay, so I'm gonna take a couple educated guesses. And I'm going to erase this, and I'm just gonna call it Big Sur APFS. Okay, and if I'm thinking about this correctly, it should automatically clean that up, which it looks like it did. Good. I think I did it right. Okay, so my other data on the drive is left untouched. I use this for like Final Cut Pro editing and stuff like that, and that is right there, so that should be good. Okay, formatting is done now. Since the public beta is now out, man, it came out way later than normal, we can use the macOS public beta utility. So let's open that up. No time machine backup detected. We like to live dangerously. We're actually installing it on an external drive, so we don't need a backup. Let's read the whole EULA. Done and install. Ugh, you can't look at this part. Okay, update not found. Great, okay, that's horrible. Oh, hey, there's the beta. Okay, I'm gonna close out of that for now because again, we're not installing this internally, so we're gonna use the feedback assistant on the external drive once it's there. So we should just be able to say upgrade. And it should, 2 hours, 1 hour remaining. Okay, I was about to jump off a cliff, although I don't think there are any cliffs 10 stories underground. Anyway. Okay, so it's gonna download the app installer, and we should be able to open the app installer, select the external drive right there, Big Sur, and install to that, just so we don't F up anything on the internal drive here. So, I'll check back with you guys in 53 minutes. 1 hour. 2 hours. It was at 3, now it's back to 2. You know, this literally just launched today, so I'm sure Apple's servers are getting slammed a little bit. I only tested beta 1 so far because beta 2, I think I tried again on beta 3 and it just would not download for some reason. Oh well, still got beta 1 If you haven't seen the video I made about it, talking about the user interface, definitely go check it out. It's kind of fun looking back on it. I'm guessing a lot of that stuff has been fixed by now. That's gonna be one of the things we test out today once we get the installation finished. We're gonna see if those bugs and design issues got squashed. 4 minutes left on the, 3 minutes left on the download now. All right, well, this has been going for about an hour. And we haven't even started the installation phase yet, so I think we're not gonna make it with our battery life there. Aw, short-lived dream. Okay, right when I walk away, it changes the screen. Oh, hey, good, it's done with that part. MagSafe. Get in there. Good, good. It's been a long day. It's been a long week. It's been a long month. It's been a long everything. It was March yesterday, now it's August. What the sh-? That is a beautiful, beautiful view of Big Sur. I am not a linguist, but I think that is some language for Big South. I could be wrong. I should probably check my information on that. All right, agree. Show all disks, and here is the Big Sur drive we have so we don't F up anything internally. You gotta close your eyes. And there we are. We are now in the next phase where we get to wait another 14 minutes. Okay, so what do you want to talk about? Lovely sports team we're having. Closing applications, here we go. Oh, going back. Didn't want to shut down all the way just yet. Oh, now you're going, okay. Okay, well we got an Apple instead of a Ghostbusters symbol, so that's a good start. Looks like it's already doing a reboot. Making sure it didn't go to sleep on me, okay. Fans are running, just waiting for it to do its thing. And it completely shut down. Okay, this happened when I was installing Catalina, man, and that wasn't even a beta. Yeah, the fans just turned off, everything shut down. So, oh wait, hang on. It just made a noise. I didn't even press anything. Now it made another noise. Okay, okay, all right, well, okay, now it's going. It's a 7-year-old computer. We'll cut it a little slack. Okay, this is what I was waiting for. About 29 minutes remaining, this might still reboot one more time or so, but this is the final part of the installation process. Pretty easy, very minimalist looking. All right, we just had our next reboot. Well, the progress bar is chugging along, so it looks like we'll be able to test drive Big Sur soon. But real quick, I just want to thank Linode for sponsoring this episode. No matter what skill level you're at, or what technology stack you use, Linode makes it easy to give your creations their own personal space on the internet. If you just need something small, like a simple website, game server, or personal VPN, Linode has you covered. If you need to manage tons of websites and reliably serve them to millions of visitors, well, guess what? Linode can do that too. Unlike entry-level hosting services that lock you into their platform, Linode gives you full back-end access to customize and control your server to fit your needs. Their DNS manager allows you to easily switch your domain to your new server, and SSL certificates can be installed for free using open-source tools. And here's another cool thing. If you run into any problems getting set up, Linode comes with amazing 24/7 customer support by phone or ticket, along with hundreds of docs to help get you started. And because you're here, and because we're all best friends, you amazing Computer Clan viewers get a free $20 credit on a new Linode account. You can sign up with the link in the description. All right, now back to the Mac. And we're rebooting again. Ooh, the faster moving progress bar. I think we're in the home stretch here. All right, we got cursor, and it moves. So that pretty much means we're done. Okay, oh, the bar just reset itself. Okay, all right, well, I spoke too soon, apparently. This is a patience exercise. Please keep your hands, arms, and mental sanity inside the exercise at all times. And another reboot. Got the Apple back, and hopefully this is it. Please. So we can get on with our lives. Oh, here we go. This is it for real now. Boom! Gray screen. And then we should get that new colorful, beautiful setup screen. There it is. With the sexy new glyphs. Oh, beautiful. I'm not sure which region I'm in, but I'm gonna guess it's this one. Continue. And yes, in case you haven't noticed already, or in case you don't know, the whole interface has been redesigned, so we'll definitely take a look at that. And, nope, I'm gonna do that later. Don't really need to set up my Apple ID with this for now. And as you can see, instead of the sheets sliding down from the top of the window, they now just kind of pop up in the middle, so that's another user interface tweak. Everything's been tweaked. It's pretty much all new. Okay, well, We don't have a photo on here, so let's choose one of the account pictures. I guess we could do the bowling, I guess. Oh, this is a lovely selection of photos. I'm going to choose this one. Oh, it's a football. Football? What's a football? Okay. Obscure reference. Anyone get that? No? Okay. Don't really need location services because I'm 10 stories underground. I know where I am. Oh, well, that might have been nice for the time zone. Well, we'll say Chicago. Not Kansas City. Not Minneapolis. Not Kansas City. There we go. Chicago. Continue. Dude, I love these new animations. Oh, the little things. Analytics, yes, it's a beta, so you kind of need to have that on. Screen time, no. I don't need to be reminded how long I use my computer. Siri, yeah, I can do things myself, thankfully. We don't need you. Ooh, yes. Oh, dark mode, light mode. Dark mode, light mode. What do you think? What do you normally use? And here we go. And here we are. We are in macOS Big Sur public beta numero uno. So let's see if they fixed some of the beefs I had. So it looks like they're sticking with the design of the messages and FaceTime icon. And, you know, I'm not really against the design. I just don't think it really matches a lot of the other design language. Because you have, like, flatter looks over here. And then you have, like, these really, like, extruded kind of looks over here. It's like a mix of, like, flat and, like, neomorphism-ish. So, I mean, we'll get used to it, I guess. It's not the worst thing. But in my opinion, it's also not the best thing. Okay, so, battery preferences, let's go ahead and pop into there. Yep, they fixed it. This needs a little bit of work because that text is way too close to the edge. This is my audit, by the way. This is part of the test spin. This is my auditing process. It is kind of cool, though. We do have on-screen usage, battery level, last 24 hours, last 10 days, kind of like what we have on iOS. That's really handy, and yes, the icon looks so much better. They fixed the bell icon's resolution. Last time it was kind of chunky looking. I mean, it's looking better though. It really is looking better. So that makes me happy. Okay, let's check another thing. Alignment of menus. Vertically, yep, everything looks good there. Let's open the force quit window. I mean, it looks better. I'd have to look at it side by side to see if it was off, but last time this red button, the close button was like way too close to the edge, but now it seems comfortable, so. Either my perception is wrong, or they actually fixed that, so. Subtle things, looking good. All right, so yeah, some of the new features we have, obviously a new design. We have control center up here. Going to display here, yay. Display, we can change the brightness, just like you would on your phone. I still think they should add like some sort of back button up here so you know where to click to go back a level. So I think that could use a little refinement. Control center, or excuse me, notification center. I mean, that's looking pretty good. I know it's kind of weird that you have to click the clock and the date to get that. I guess that makes sense. Either way, it looks pretty. I think they're doing this with Swift UI. Looks really nice, consistent with how iOS looks. We can add in our own widgets. So we can put our reminders in there, stocks, so I can be depressed at how much Kodak has gone up and I wonder why I didn't keep investing in them. Screen time, we can drag that into here. That's pretty, that looks really good there. Alrighty, swipe that away. Safari, big new changes in Safari. The computer clan, the computer clan wallpapers is a Google suggestion. What are you guys searching? Do you guys only want our wallpapers? Is that what you guys are searching all the time? Well, good for you. So we'll go to our incredibly out of date website. We can test a new feature while we're here. This is like the new privacy report for the website. Let's click on it. Two trackers prevented, there's trackers on our website, seriously? Oh, Google Analytics, well, that's totally fine. Do we need a disclaimer on our website for using Google Analytics? Not even sure. Maybe we should put one on there. But yeah, that's all we have on our, hold the phone, does that mean I'm not gonna get analytics? Analytic data from people using the new version of Safari? So if you visit our website, I'm not gonna know that information? What the hell? Seriously? Or do I still, I don't know what profiling really means. I need to look into that. I'm not a cybersecurity expert, but that is interesting. What if I press the I button? Oh, this is like the help thing. Anyway, that is a cool feature though. That really is. So, what's a cool wallpaper? I mean, I have a few good ones. We can download this one. This as the desktop picture. Look at that. Okay, so something that I believe is specifically new to the latest betas is a new version of WebKit that supports VP9, finally. I really don't know why it took so long for Apple to get VP9 in their stuff, but apparently it took forever. Okay, so the biggest feature from that most of you will benefit from, 4K playback on YouTube, because that relies on VP9. You couldn't do that in Safari until potentially now. Let's find out. Let's go to, why not, my iPhone 12 video, which has a whopping like 4 views. So let's say no thanks and go to that. Let's see here. Scrolling up, 4K? Oh, it only took like, 4 years to get that in there? Oh, finally, I can watch 4K YouTube in Safari. I don't have to go to Chrome anymore. Oh, Apple, thank you. Wow, this looks good. I mean, the sad thing is, it's not really sad, but this is not a 4K display, so I'm not even seeing, pixel accuracy here, but wow, that looks sharp still. You can still easily tell the difference between 1080p and 4K. Oh gosh, that looks so crisp. I just want to lick it. Is that weird? Another thing I heard about is you can turn off the window tinting, which someone actually tweeted me about recently. He was like, purple dark mode. Well, dark mode, what dark mode does is it takes, I think light mode does this too, I'm not sure, but the average color of your wallpaper is like tinted into the dark mode. So it's very hard to see, but it's subtle. So this isn't like a gray, this is like a very like desaturated bluish green going on up here. It does that. It's, I think they call it like window tinting or something. I wanna see. Oh yeah, allow wallpaper tinting in windows. So if I turn that off, you can now see the difference there. That's the gray dark mode and this is the tinted version, but I don't mind the tinted version. I think it looks pretty. I'm very confident this is gonna be a great release, and it's also gonna be the first operating system for Apple Silicon. Apple is moving away from Intel chips to their own silicon like they use in the iPhone, but only, way more powerful. So this is a good way to pave that roadmap for the future. I actually did a Tech Talk episode about Apple Silicon, so if you wanna learn more about it, I highly recommend checking that one out. That's a good one. Okay, so there is one thing I have not checked yet. I heard the screenshot sound changed. I guess there was some controversy around the little bleep sound. So let's see how it sounds now. Ooh. So they brought back the original sound that I think Jim Reeks, who made the startup chime, made, but they combined it with like a little bloop bloop. Okay. Actually, the camera shutter does sound a little bit different too, or maybe I'm just crazy. I like that though. I'm not stopping. Okay, well, the desktop looks good. Okay, so Big Sur, you're on your way. You're looking pretty good. I can't wait to try you out when you go final. My heart sank when I said that. I usually wait a little bit until I update on my daily driver, which hopefully soon will be that new iMac. So, pretty cool stuff. Let me know what you think about macOS Big Sur, and let me know of any other bugs and little things that you saw. I also did notice the dock menu highlighting still isn't rounded like everything else is, so I guess there's still a few design things they need to fix, but that's what the feedback assistant is for. Let me know what you guys think, and if you want to support the channel, feel free to click the join button below the video, or you can click that awesome link in the description. And if you like the video, you know what to do. Thanks for sticking with me, catch the crazy, and pass it on.